Here we want to graph a square root function, and we're going to use the translations to do that. The first step is to identify your basic graph, and that is the square root function, okay, square root of x. We know what that looks like. Then we're going to identify our translations. Well, let's first see that we have that negative. We're going to always do reflections first. That's a reflection about the x-axis. Okay, and then the last translation here will be our final graph. When you subtract 2 inside the argument of the square root, that's a horizontal translation. Okay, that's a shift right 2 units. Certainly, if we had a plus 2, that would be a shift left 2 units. Okay, and there's no vertical translation here. So let's go ahead and graph these up. Okay, so graphing the basic graph first, when I plug in 0, square root of 0, 0, square root of 1 is 1, and the square root of 4 is 2. So try to do this dotted here. Our basic graph, y equals square root of x, looks like this. Okay, now let's do the reflection about the x-axis. Okay, so 0, 0 would still be a point. When I plug in 1 there, I'd get negative 1. And then plugging in 4, I get negative 2. So when I reflect that about the x-axis, I get something that looks like this. Okay, and then for our final graph, what we're going to do is take that and shift it to the right 2 units. Okay, so this point shifted to the right will give me a point there. X value there would be 3. And when I shift this 2 units, the x value would be 6. Okay, so for my final graph, sorry about that, but that's best I can do on the computer. Here's the graph of f of x. What you do want to notice too, though, is the domain. Notice x values greater than 2 are in the domain. Anything less is not. Well, look at the original, right? Okay, 2 minus 2 is 0. If you plug in 1, you'd have 1 minus 2, which is a negative argument inside the square root. That's imaginary. So here's the basic graph of f of x using translations.